Yeah, good morning and hello everybody. Welcome to our webinar, Updates Free at Home and Secure at Home. My name is Thorsten Reibel. Yeah, I'm together with Martin Vichary at ABB Bulsjäger in Lüdenscheid. Martin will run this webinar today. Yeah, before we start, some organizational topics. Yeah, the webinar will run around 1 hour as always, and we record this webinar. So we'll send you afterwards a feedback email together with a recording of this webinar and also the presentation. So if you have questions, please send it in the chat to all participants so that everybody can see your question. And we will try to answer during the webinar, but latest finally at the end of the webinar. Good, so I hand over to Martin now, just a moment. So, Martin, you can continue now.
Yeah, thank you, Thorsten, and good morning and hello also from my side. Thank you, Thorsten, for the introduction. My name is Martin Vichary. I'm based here in Lüdenscheid at Bulsjäger. And yeah, as Thorsten said, the topic for today will be mainly free at home and secure at home. So we want to show you some updates, some new features, and mainly also the integration. So how can we integrate secure at home into free at home? So I will start with the presentation now. 1 second, please. So, what is on the agenda today? So I want to start with the integration of secure at home into free at home. So we will start with a short summary about secure at home for everyone, for you who is maybe new or not so familiar with secure at home. We will show you how the system looks like. Then we will show you the commissioning part in free at home. This is important. And this will also take most of the time today. After that, we will talk about some new features in free at home. So some new devices like the alarm stick, and yeah, this is available now, and this we also want to present you today. Okay, so first of all, we start with a general overview about secure at home. Most of you might know this is also not our first webinar about secure at home, but still, for everyone who is new maybe or who didn't saw our latest webinars about secure at home, we want to give you a short general overview. So what is ABB Secure at Home? Secure at Home is an easy-to-use anti-intrusion system. And what is important, it can be integrated into our smart home system free at home. So with this system, we more or less complete our home automation portfolio. So in addition to our smart home system free at home and our door communication system Welcome, we also have now a security system for the residential segment. What are the main applications here in Secure at Home? So first of all, we have of course, outdoor protection means on the one hand, of course, infrared sensors, which are positioned somewhere in the outdoor spaces, for example, in the garden. Yeah, then we have some bidirectional detectors for door and window for doors and windows to protect the entrances more or less of the house. Yeah, the second application is of course the indoor protection. So for the indoor protection, we have first of all also movement detectors and as well perimeter detection sensors for windows, doors, or main or secondary entrances. The next application is about smoke and flue protection. So here we also have some sensors to detect smoke, heat, or water damages, for example. This is in a house, of course, also important that we can protect these segments. And the last application, which is also the main topic for today, is the smart home integration. So we will later see how we can integrate Secure at Home into Free at Home and how we can set up scenes, actions, how we can use the remote access, and so on. So all the applications which are important for available with Free at Home, we will see later on. So here an overview about all devices which are available. So first of all, our system devices. So our central unit, one version with GSM, one without GSM, available in black and in white. This device is always needed. This is important to know. So in a secure at home system, we always need this central unit. Then we have a remote control. We have an outdoor siren. Then, of course, all our indoor and outdoor detectors, our movement detectors, our magnetic contacts. So all the devices which detect someone, intruders, and so on. And last, our safety devices, the smoke detector, the heat detector, and the water detector. So I say it one more time, in this webinar, we will not go into the details of each sensor, so how each of them works. So if you're interested in more details about the sensors, you can have a look at our former webinars or at our former slides we presented. There you find much more details about each device. Still, we want to present you the most important aspects here of Secure at Home. So first aspect, of course, the system must be secure, which means we use here an encrypted protocol with a rolling code for all signals. We use CSMA technology. This technology makes more or less or guarantees us that the band is not occupied when we send out messages into the system, so that no signals get lost. Second aspect, flexible, means here that we can place and install the sensors wherever we want. So without brickwork, we have battery powered sensors. So here we can place them where we want and where they provide me the most security. Simple and integrated refers also to the commissioning part of the system. So you will see later on, especially in combination with Free at Home, we have a really simple way to commission the system. Okay, before we start now with the integration, some more details about the wireless technology we use here. So for all of you who know Free at Home, you know that we also have some wireless devices available in Free at Home. But here we have some differences between the wireless devices from Secure at Home and from Free at Home, which I want to show you here now. So first of all, we are using here the 868 megahertz frequency according to European norms for security systems. Then we use the CSMA technology, which I just explained. And together with the high distances here for Free at Home, it makes the whole system quite very reliable, which is important, of course. Then, of course, due to the fact that we are dealing here with the security of our home, of our house, it's very important to have a high data protection. So we are using here the 128-bit encryption. We have around 65,000 rolling codes to encrypt all of our signals, our commands. So this is, of course, also important that no one from outside can somehow jam the system. So what are the differences now? So you see, first of all, that we have a different target or different aim for both systems. So we have security on the one hand and home automation on the other hand. We are using another band for both systems, so 868 and here 2.4 gigahertz. We have a bi-directional communication in Secure at Home. So you see the communication always goes only from one sensor to the central unit. We have a direct connection here. And in Free at Home, we build up a mesh network between the devices. So this is, of course, also a big difference. yeah, the wireless technology, this is, of course, yeah, more or less what I just said. So we have a bi-directional communication between all sensors and the central unit, means in the installation, I directly connect each device with my central unit. This makes, of course, the placing of the devices quite easy. If I have longer distances, I can also use the repeater. So here I'm really flexible to place all of my sensors which I need in my installation. Important is, of course, then the connection to FreeAtHome. There we will see how we establish the connection later on in detail. Yeah, and all in all, we can say that we have a fully integrated system now. So we have for residential buildings, FreeAtHome, our home automation system. We have Bush ABB Welcome, our door communication system, and with SecureAtHome now, our security system. So all three systems can work together. We can combine them. We can create actions and so on. So we have a quite good and complete solution for villas, houses, or all residential projects here. Okay, so enough for SecureAtHome itself. So as I said, if you need more information, please check our slides, our webinars, and so on. I want to go now into or start with some details about the integration into FreeAtHome. So we have more or less one example for today. We have a full installation of FreeAtHome with some actuators, some panels, and so on. And we have also a small SecureAtHome installation with some sensors, some magnetic contacts. And the first question is now, how do I connect SecureAtHome and FreeAtHome? And you already see here the connection, so the answer is also quite easy. And I think also clear for you, we have to connect the central unit of SecureAtHome with the FreeAtHome bus. So means the central unit acts more or less like a normal FreeAtHome device on our bus, means it will be also automatically detected in my FreeAtHome system when I connect the central unit to my FreeAtHome bus. What is important to have on your mind is that if you have a renovation object where you have maybe only wireless devices and you don't use a bus cable, you need somehow still the power supply for the bus, because the connection from SecureAtHome to FreeAtHome, from central unit to system access point, is established only via the bus. So here it's not possible to have a wireless connection here, means you always need also the power supply. This is of course important to have in your mind. So which functions we can create now with the integration, or what benefits we have here? So we can use functions like arming and disarming. We can use scenes, actions, remote control. So these are the typical features which I get from FreeAtHome. And what is maybe more important and which brings us more comfort here is of course the full configuration by FreeAtHome, means I can add sensors, I can create zones, I can create some interaction between the sensors. So this is what I want to show you now. So in general, I will now start with or I will show you now how we can commission the system, how we can commission FreeAtHome and SecureAtHome. I will start with a live demonstration then in the FreeAtHome interface, but before we start this, there are some small steps needed we have to fulfill in SecureAtHome, means directly on the central unit. So when you connect or when you power the central unit, you have your system now established, all devices are placed. what is important, what you have to do. So when you power up the central unit, you will have to run through a short short wizard, which is the more or less the main first steps. So first of all, we have to select the language. We have to create a pin for the installer, and this is also the first important thing we have to do, and which you have which you should remember. So the first pin for the installer is also the pin which we need later when we set up the installation in FreeRTOM. So here in my installation, I use now the very simple pin 00000, so easy to remember for me in the live demonstration later. The next step is already the pairing between FreeRTOM and SecureRTOM. So also the central unit will realize that there is a connection to a FreeRTOM system, and then he will ask you if you want to pair both systems. So the easiest way would be to do the pairing now. So you just send a small key. So you click OK and the key is sent. You could also do this later on, but the easiest way would be, of course, to do it now. Yeah, then some information about date and time are needed. I think this is clear. Then next step, and this is again important, this is also almost the last step, is to we have to read in all sensors of SecureRTOM now. So what do I have to do now? You will see on your screen that the sensor setup is now started, and he is looking for sensors in the installation. So now I can go to my first sensor, or I can take the first sensor and I put in the battery, and after I power the device, the central unit will automatically detect the new sensor and will read it into the installation. So you will get in general an acoustic feedback, and a small message like sensor found will be displayed on the screen. If you don't want to put in the battery in, it's also possible just to trigger the sensor. So for example, for a movement detector, you can just go with your hand in front of the movement detector, it should appear. And for the remote control, for example, it's just enough to click one button to read it in, and for the magnetic contact, it's also enough to trigger the input, so to close the contact or open the contact. So this is also possible. Here you can do both. You can power the devices, or you can trigger the sensor. Yeah, and this was mainly all. So now we can finish the setup. And after finishing, we only have to create one more user, and this is now the user for the end user, so not the installer user, really the end user. So here, this is the user more or less who will later on arm and disarm the system in theory. So the user for the people who really live there. Here I use the password 5 times the one, also to keep it simple. So this is my password for the end user. And when I also finish that, I will see a notification on the small screen that I now can configure everything in FreeRTOM. So the rest is also completely done in FreeRTOM. And this is what I also want to show you now. So just let me quickly share my screen. First of all, I will log in, of course, into my system. So I prepared a small FreeRTOM installation here, where I have some different rooms, some different devices integrated here. But what I recommend first, or what I do always when I start with the commissioning of SecureRTOM and FreeRTOM, is that I go to the preferences, and I will see here in the preferences on the left side where my integrations are. So where all the functions like Sonos, like Philips Hue are, I see now here Secure at Home. And when I click on Secure at Home on the central unit, I also see now the number of the central unit, and I see here the button Delete AES Key. So when I see here the button Delete AES Key, it's the sign for me that the connection between Free at Home and Secure at Home is established now. If there is a problem or the key is not sent correctly or there was a failure in the when both systems were connected, then this AES key wouldn't be available here. But now I see it is available, so I could delete it. Of course, I don't delete it now because I want to show you the commissioning, but I know now that both systems are paired correctly. So means I can go now to the devices menu and I can start with the commissioning part now. So I have one floor here, and what I already did, I inserted the ABB central unit into my installation. So this is always also the first step. What I should do, I should always start with the central unit, put this one in, and then I start with the different sensors. So on the bottom side, you see now here also that I have the icon for Secure at Home. And when I click on the icon, you see all the different sensors which are integrated into the system or into my installation. The first step of commissioning now would be to create the zones and add the different devices I have here automatically to my zones. So here in this case, I select first of all a movement detector and I put it to the hall. And you see now here the system finds one Secure at Home central unit and one movement detector which is integrated into my Secure at Home system. So this device was powered, as I showed you, with the battery. I inserted or I added it to my Secure at Home installation, and now I can add it here to my Free at Home. So I select it, I click next, and now the next question from the system is, now I have to create one zone for the or my first zone for the movement detector here. So I click on create new zone, and now this is also important. The system asks me for the number of the installer plus or followed by the 5-digit PIN. So means the PIN, this is clear, this is the PIN I just created in the beginning when I set up my secure home system for the first time. The number of the installer is, this is also important that you remember this, the number of the installer is the number of user I have created. So I started with the installer, this was the first user I created, and we always start to count with zero, means the installer is the number zero, and then I enter the PIN, so also 5 times the zero, and then I have the PIN for my installer. So now I have created the first zone, zone A, and I can add now the movement detector to my zone A. So the same I can do more or less for all different devices I have now in my installation. So next I could take, for example, a window sensor. I put it to the living room here. You see I have two different magnetic contacts integrated here. Now I do the same. I select this one. I create again a new zone. Now zone B is created, and I put this one now into zone B. So this is mainly all what I have to do with my sensors. So this way I add the sensors into my installation, I put them into my zones, and this way I create really all different zones in my security system. What else do you have? This I also already integrated is the remote control. So the remote control to arm and disarm the system remotely. So this I already integrated also here in the hall. You will also see later what is possible with the remote control here. So what I want to do now, or what is the main function of the system now, is of course to I want to arm and disarm the system with RearTome. And here we have mainly two things we have to think about, or what is important. So the first option to test the arming and disarming function directly here in the configuration would be that I go to my actions and profiles. So here on the top left side, I have my actions and profiles. And here I see now that all the two zones which I created are available. I have one global zone. So this is the global arming when I want to arm all zones. And I have the safety zone, or the 24-hour zone. In this zone are all smoke and heat detectors automatically connected. So every time I add one smoke detector from Securitome or one water detector from Securitome, it will be automatically detected here into my safety zone. So I could test now the arming function by clicking on one zone, for example, zone B. And what you directly see is that the icon for zone B is gray now. So I can't change it now. I can't arm or disarm the system. The reason is, when you have a look here on the top right side, I have this small lock icon, and the lock icon is at the moment open. And this means that the configuration of Securitome is at the moment opened. And if I want to arm or disarm the system, I have to close this configuration first of all. So it's not allowed to arm or disarm the system while you are configuring the system. So now he again asked me for the number of the installer, followed by the 5-digit PIN, means 6x0 now for me. And now I can close the configuration of Securitome. So now I can go again to zone B. And now you see the icon is not gray anymore. I can click on the icon and I can create, or I can change or arm, for example, zone B. Now, after a short delay, I will get another notification. And now he's asking me again for a PIN. But now, this time, please enter the number of the user followed by the 5-digit PIN. Means now I don't need the installer. Now I need the user, so the end user account which I created. It was the second user I've created, so now the number would be 1 and the PIN was 5x1 again. I enter it and now the system will be armed. Or not the whole system, but at least zone B will be armed now. So this is, of course, the first option, how I can arm and disarm the system or test the different functions here in Securitome. Of course, you can now directly add the different zones to the panel. So this is the first easy option, how you can create or how you can arm or disarm the system. So I have here in my system, for example, the 7-inch panel, and I could now go to the configuration of the 7-inch panel. And when you filter now for all functions, so you really need to go back, you need to search for all functions, and then you will see now also the different zones. You could add now, for example, the global zone to your panel, and then you could arm or disarm the system by the 7-inch panel. Same also, of course, for the 4.3-inch panel. So this is now the first option, how I can arm or disarm the system from with FreeAtHome. Second option would be, of course, to use the FreeAtHome app. So this is of course also possible. You will see the small icons like you know it as always. The third option, and this is now also important, if you want to have some automation, maybe some more comfort, then you can also use scenes to arm and disarm the system. To do this, you have to think about one important thing. I go back to the hall now and I will select now the central unit. And you see here you have three different parameters. And the first parameter is the important one, allow system to be disarmed by scenes. Default is here the answer no. You can also select yes. With this setting, you can establish or you can make sure that you can arm and disarm the system by scenes. So by default, it's only possible to arm them, not to disarm. We say it's not 100% secure if you do this also by scenes, just for the case that you do it by chance. But if you want to do both, then you have to select this parameter here to yes. Just to show you how this works, now I have to put in first of all the installer pin one more time. Just to show you how this works, I will do both. So arming and disarming, and I prepared two different scenes, one for arming, one for disarming. And now I can select for example, the arming scene. I go to my zones and I could select now, for example, the global zone, the zone A or the zone B. So for this example, I just take the zone B. I take the global one just to show you how it's working for all zones. So here again, I would select now the status for arming and disarming. So in this case, I have to change here the setting. Of course, it's not working now because I have to lock first of all the configuration. So as I said, it's not allowed to arm or disarm the system when the configuration is opened. So here I have to enter the PIN one more time. And now, when I go back to my scene, I select now the global one, and now I'm able to arm the whole system now for my scene. Again, after I wait a little bit, I have to put in now the user pin. So same process like always, I have to put it in, and then the system, wrong ping. So by the way, when you enter the wrong pin, you will get this notification that the pin is wrong. So one more time, I arm the system. I waited a little bit. Now he's asking for the user pin and the 5 digits. So I put it in and now the zone will be armed. I can save this and then I have one scene to arm the system. So this scenes can be now combined, of course, with sensors as you know it. So if you say I want to connect the right rocker here, for example, to my scene, then I could use this rocker to arm my system. Same could be done, of course, then for disarming, which I didn't configure it yet. But here you have to put in the disarming scene. And so you could say I want to arm and disarm the system by a rocker. And of course, which is maybe the most comfortable way, would be that you create an action. So I go to my action, I have one scene for leaving, and my leaving scene could be triggered, for example, by a binary input, which I just prepared. So a window sensor, for example, you could say I use a door bar contact. So this is a normal FreeAtome binary input where you could, which is connected maybe to a magnetic contact in the door. So means when I lock my door, I want to activate, for example, my arming scene and, for example, an all-off scene, which is here. So this way you would establish that each time when you leave your house and you really close your door, so you lock your door, that the arming scene, the system will be armed, and the all-off scene, which shut down all, or which switch off all the lights, will be activated. Same you could do, of course, for entering the house. So means when you open the door, then the disarming function is activated. So last thing, what is important? I said we have a full integration into our system, means I can now mix FreeAtHome and SecureAtHome functions and actions. So you saw it already in the actions. I could mix now FreeAtHome binary inputs, for example, and SecureAtHome functions. And what is also possible is that you now use a FreeAtHome movement detector like this one to connect with a normal FreeAtHome light. So this is also possible, of course. So I could use this movement detector, which is in general only there to establish the security of my house. But I could use it now also when it's not armed to work as a movement detector, to switch on a light in the floor, for example. This is possible, but of course you should have in your mind that when you do this, the battery of the SecureAtHome sensors will be empty faster than when you only use it as a security device. And the last thing, in the beginning you saw I entered here, or added here, the SecureAtHome remote control. So the remote control to arm and disarm the system. And you can see I have the possibility to connect this remote control with one of my scenes. So for example, with the all-off scene. On the remote control, you have one button. It's the button on the bottom left side with a small plus icon. This button can be used to control one FreeAtHome function. So you can use the remote control of SecureAtHome to arm and disarm the system. You can activate the panic alarm, but you can also activate one scene in FreeAtHome. This is why we can add it here into the installation and connect it with one of our scenes. So this is mainly everything for SecureAtHome. I want to show you now some more details about new functions in FreeAtHome. So I will stop sharing for the moment and jump back into the presentation. Programmed alarm units. So, and after that, so in this installation, I programmed, for example, 4 units. I can deactivate the coding mode, and then I can use all devices in my installation also. So I'm now back in my installation here. And first of all, I can show you now under preferences. Here you would find now under integrations, as I said, the FreeAtHome alarm stick. Here you have one more time also some explanations how you read in the different detectors. And here you could also activate now the coding mode again if you want to add some more devices, for example. So back to the main menu, back to my device menu. You see again here in my list of devices which are available now also the alarm unit. And you see we can differentiate between smoke and heat alarm units and CO alarm units. So I could start, for example, now with one CO alarm unit. I only have one in my device. in my installation, so I could directly edit. And I could also add, for example, a smoke and heat alarm into my installation. Here you see now three different sensors. And what is important, the number which you see here is printed, as I said, on the label of the radio module. So this label can be also put into your documentation that you know which detector is located in which room. So here, for my example, it doesn't matter which one I take. I just select them, put them in, and this is what I could do now for all my different sensors. So what I can do now, what are some basic functions? First of all, it's possible now to combine a smoke or a heat detector, or also, of course, a carbon monoxide sensor with a scene of Free at Home. So when I click on it, you can see that I can connect now one or two scenes for with this sensor. What happens here when I connect it with a panic scene, for example? You can read here, fire alarm starts. So means when the sensor is or an alarm is triggered, that the panic scene will be activated. And I could also define, for example, one scene when the fire alarm ends. So this is now directly possible here in the installation, in the device menu. Of course, I could also go to my actions menu and do the same here. So I prepared here also one action for fire alarm. And as an event, I could now select the smoke and heat alarm unit, for example. I say when fire alarm starts, a light should go on and I get a notification to my panel, to my mobile phone, per email, however I want. What you can see here, when I selected the smoke and heat alarm, I can't select one of the devices. When I put in here one of the devices, it doesn't matter which detects or which triggers the alarm. All of them are connected, means all of them will also activate this action I defined here. Yeah, this is mainly all what I can do. So I could mainly connect the sensors with different actions and different scenes. Maybe what is also important to know, all detectors and the modules have a 10 years guarantee, also a 10 years battery. And as soon as the lifetime is below 30 days, you will get an acoustic signal from the device itself. And you will also get a notification here in Free at Home. So this will be also shown in Free at Home when one of the battery is going to be empty. You will also get a notification if you remove the alarm stick. So this will also be displayed here in Free at Home. Yeah, and maybe on the other hand, what is not possible, you can't trigger a test alarm here from Free at Home. So I can't say somehow, please trigger this or that sensor. This is not possible. I can also not mute the detector here from Free at Home and also not from outside. So I still have to be on site. I still have to touch the bottom of the detector to mute it. And what is also not possible, because this is also often asked, I can't see the status of the battery here. So this is also not possible. I don't see how long this battery will still work. This is also not possible. So this is almost all for the integration of the smoke, heat and CO detectors. Maybe last, some new features or some new, some innovations which came also with the last firmware 2.4.0. So one function is now available, which you might already know, which is the double click function. The double click function was in the past only available for for wireless devices. Now it's possible also to use this double click function also for our free at home wired devices. Double click means I can connect the sensor here right side with one light and on addition with one scene. And this combination would now make it possible to switch the light on and off with the right rocker, but with a double click function of the topper side of the sensor. So a double click would now activate the panic scene here. So this is now possible and available with firmware 2.4.0. What else is new are some new details in the preferences menu. So maybe you already saw a free at home monitor is now available. So the monitor is mainly important for bug fixing. When I start the monitor and I click on one button of my installation, you see now, for example, the value of the rocker, which I just touched or pushed. So you see the channel, which is now on. So this is mainly important if you have installation where something is not working and you might ask yourself why it's not working. You can use this to find the problem of the installation. What else is possible? It's now possible to use an USB stick to update the system access point. Condition is here also, of course, that we have the new system access point with the USB ports. So here you can use now a local update from the USB stick to update the system access point. Also new or quite new are the hyperlinks. So with the hyperlinks, you can create direct links here, for example, to our ABB site, which can be displayed in the Free at Home app now. So there you have a link, for example, when you mount a tablet on the wall, there you can also directly place some links to the internet here or to also local cameras or whatever is in your network. So these hyperlinks can be used now. And the last thing, which is also new, which was also often asked by a lot of people, is the documentation. So under system information, you see here now the documentation button create. If I want to create it, you have to put in the name, the address, and so on. And this way you can create a documentation with all devices, all connections, and all realized functions, how you set up the installation. So let's start with the smoke alarm portfolio first of all. So ABB integrates the well-known smoke and heat detector and also a new carbon monoxide detector into ABB Free at Home. The connection is established with this small USB stick, about we will talk later on also more detailed. First of all, what is the motivation? Why we said, okay, we want to integrate now also smoke and heat alarm and the CO alarm into Free at Home. So the reason is clear. We want to have a holistic solution. We don't want to integrate heat alarm and smoke alarm over binary inputs anymore. So we said we need a solution which we can use directly and which is also, of course, easy to use. And the second reason is, of course, that CO is a very dangerous gas for us, and we want to make sure that we can integrate this also into ABB Free at Home to protect. Okay. First of all, what is the motivation? Why we said we need a solution here? First of all, of course, we want to provide a holistic portfolio. Means we want to integrate now also heat and smoke alarm directly into Free at Home and not over binary input. And the second reason is, of course, that we saw that especially CO is a very dangerous gas, so dangerous for human beings. And a lot of people asked for the solution, so we said it's important that we also integrate a CO alarm detector now into Free at Home. Important is also where we can use this solution or where this solution is available. So we can say that in general the solution can be used in all CE markets, mainly of course Germany, Austria, Belgium. Important is also to know that our solution for the smoke and the heat detector can't be used in countries like the Netherlands or the Nordic countries, where we need a 230 volt connection in the device, which we don't have in our portfolio at the moment. So in these countries, we can't use this. Okay, next, let's see how the integration works and which features are available. So the main condition to use the alarm stick is that we use the new system access point, which has also two USB ports. And all in all, we can connect up to 20 detectors. So it doesn't matter if we use a CO, a heat or a smoke detector. All in all, 20 detectors can be connected. And the detectors build up a network and send their signals directly to the alarm stick of Free at Home. So this way we can integrate each sensor and we can also localize an alarm now. So we see really in which room an alarm has been triggered. And we can also use other Free at Home functions like push notifications, messages for empty batteries, scene control or the control of U-lamps or Sonos in combination with an alarm, for example. So the stick itself is available in an ABB and in a Bushega version. So both has to be connected to the new system access point. So this is the main condition, as I said, to use the new system access point. What is also important is that when Free at Home has any issues, is not working, I don't know, the system access point is falling out, not available, whatever, the detectors are also working autark. So this is of course important that the system is still working, even the system access point is not available. Yeah, what else? In the package is a USB extension cable to mount the device outside of the cabinet. We are using the 868 MHz frequency, and for sure we can use it also for different functions in Free at Home. Yeah, the heat and the smoke detectors are no new devices, so we just integrate the existing devices now into Free at Home. What is important is that we need for each device, which should be integrated into Free at Home, one radio module. So this has to be inserted into the smoke and the heat alarm, and this way we can now integrate them into our system. New is this device, the carbon monoxide detector. Maybe before we talk about the device, maybe in general, what is carbon monoxide? Carbon monoxide, or just CO, is an odorless gas, and this gas is deadly for human beings. So this is why it's so dangerous, and this is why we release this device now. Yeah, the device itself has mainly one button, which is the test and mute button. And then we have a three-level signalization for the CO concentration in the room. So up to 10 ppm will nothing happen, and then up to 43 ppm we will get the first optical signal, and then from ppm value 43 and upper values you will also get an acoustic signal. And the value will be also displayed on the screen. Maybe here, to your information, these values are very, very low. So this is of course important because we want to avoid problems of CO. So first symptoms like headache or something like this will only start at a concentration of 200 ppm and after 2 to 3 hours. So this is a very low value that we can really avoid problems. Yeah, and this is the radio module for the CO alarm. So in general, we have the same lifetime, same frequency, same limitations, but we just need a new one because it has another form. So it doesn't, the old one or the other one wouldn't fit into this detector. So here we need a new radio module. And with this radio module, you can integrate then carbon monoxide detectors. So if we have a look at the statistic from Germany about the number of deaths through carbon monoxide, we can unfortunately see that the number of deaths is rising. So for a lot of people, the integration of CO detector was very important. So we are very happy now that we can offer a solution. We see here which effects CO has in our body. So I already said after 2 to 3 hours, some things like headache will start, you feel weak and something like this. And already smoking has a small effect on us, but after one cigarette, the value starts to get lower again. So this is not really dangerous in general. So it starts to get really dangerous at the value around 40+%. So there are things like unconsciousness, coma, and death can really follow. Yeah, and where CO comes from? What are the origins of CO? In general, we can say that everywhere where something burns without enough oxygen, CO arises. So for us in our homes, especially heating system, fireplaces, also pellet firing are places where it would be important to use a CO alarm. So we really recommend to install one device in each room with fireplace, heating system or chimney. Okay. We can also integrate two additional devices for the CO detector. First one is one battery-driven RF remote push-button control element. So this device can be used also for a mixed network. And what we can do with the device, we can localize an alarming device, for example. We can mute in case of a false alarm. And we can test the installation to activate all detectors centrally. So this is the main purpose for this device. Last, this device has also a memory which shows us when a CO alarm was triggered and I was not at home. So there is a small memory which stores this information. And the last device is the emergency button RF. So this is used to activate an alarm manually. So of course, more used in public buildings to raise an alarm. I guess not so important for family houses or villas, but maybe more important like when you have a project, kindergarten or a building like that. So more definitely in public buildings. Okay, so the installation, what do we have to do? Which preconditions I have to fulfill? So first of all, I need the firmware 2.4.0 and I need the new system access point with the USB sticks, with the USB connectors. And then we have to connect the alarm stick to the system access point, and as soon it will recognize the stick, there will appear a menu under integrations in the preference menu. So where you also find Philips Hue, for example, there you will find also the ABB Free at Home alarm stick now. So now we have to activate the coding mode, and then we network all detectors. Means we put the radio module into the detector. We press the LED of the interface. So of the radio module, there is a small button, LED button, and this we have to press. This LED will then turn red or blue depending on which device you have. And in the interface, you see now how many programmed alarm units has been learned in or married with the system. Yeah, and after you have programmed all devices, you can deactivate the coding mode and start to commission the system. Okay, so what is possible now in Free at Home? I will show you in a live demonstration again. So let me share my screen, please.
So I'm now back in my installation here. And first of all, I can show you now under preferences. Here you would find now under integrations, as I said, the Free at Home alarm stick. Here you have one more time also some explanations how you read in the different detectors. And here you could also activate now the coding mode again if you want to add some more devices, for example. So back to the main menu, back to my device menu. You see again here in my list of devices which are available now also the alarm unit. And you see we can differentiate between smoke and heat alarm units and CO alarm units. So I could start, for example, now with one CO alarm unit. I only have one in my device, in my installation, so I could directly add it. And I could also add, for example, a smoke and heat alarm into my installation. Here you see now three different sensors. And what is important, the number which you see here is printed, as I said, on the label of the radio module. So this label can be also put into your documentation that you know which detector is located in which room. So here, for my example, it doesn't matter which one I take. I just select them, put them in, and this is what I could do now for all my different sensors. So what I can do now, what are some basic functions? First of all, it's possible now to combine a smoke or a heat detector, or also, of course, a carbon monoxide sensor with a scene of Free at Home. So when I click on it, you can see that I can connect now one or two scenes for with this sensor. What happens here when I connect it with a panic scene, for example? You can read here, fire alarm starts. So means when the sensor is or an alarm is triggered, that the panic scene will be activated. And I could also define, for example, one scene when the fire alarm ends. So this is now directly possible here in the installation, in the device menu. Of course, I could also go to my actions menu and do the same here. So I prepared here also one action for fire alarm. And as an event, I could now select the smoke and heat alarm unit, for example. I say when fire alarm starts, a light should go on and I get a notification to my panel, to my mobile phone, per email, however I want. What you can see here, when I selected the smoke and heat alarm, I can't select one of the devices. When I put in here one of the devices, it doesn't matter which detects or which triggers the alarm. All of them are connected, means all of them will also activate this action I defined here. Yeah, this is mainly all what I can do. So I could mainly connect the sensors with different actions and different scenes. Maybe what is also important to know, all detectors and the modules have a 10 years guarantee, also a 10 years battery. And as soon as the lifetime is below 30 days, you will get an acoustic signal from the device itself, and you will also get a notification here in Free at Home. So this will be also shown in Free at Home when one of the battery is going to be empty. You will also get a notification if you remove the alarm stick. So this will also be displayed here in Free at Home. And maybe on the other hand, what is not possible You can't trigger a test alarm here from FreeAtom, so I can't say somehow, please trigger this or that sensor. This is not possible. I can also not mute the detector here from FreeAtom and also not from outside. So I still have to be on site. I still have to touch the bottom of the detector to mute it. And what is also not possible, because this is also often asked, I can't see the status of the battery here. So this is also not possible. I don't see how long this battery will still work. This is also not possible. So this is almost all for the integration of the smoke, heat and CO detectors. Maybe last, some new features or some new some innovations which came also with the last firmware 2.4.0. So one function is now available, which you might already know, which is the double click function. The double click function was in the past only available for wireless devices. Now it's possible also to use this double click function also for our FreeAtom wired devices. Double click means I can connect the sensor here right side with one light and on addition with one scene. And this combination would now make it possible to switch the light on and off with the right rocker, but with a double click function of the topper side of the sensor. So a double click would now activate the panic scene here. So this is now possible and available with firmware 2.4.0. What else is new are some new details in the preferences menu. So maybe you already saw a FreeAtom monitor is now available. So the monitor is mainly important for bug fixing. When I start the monitor and I click on one button of my installation, you see now, for example, the value of the rocker which I just touched or pushed. So you see the channel which is now on. So this is mainly important if you have installation where something is not working and you might ask yourself why it's not working. You can use this to find the problem of the installation. What else is possible? It's now possible to use a USB stick to update the system access point. Condition is here also, of course, that we have the new system access point with the USB ports. So here you can use now a local update from the USB stick to update the system access point. Also new or quite new are the hyperlinks. So with the hyperlinks, you can create direct links here, for example, to our ABB site, which can be displayed in the FreeAtom app now. So there you have a link, for example, when you mount a tablet on the wall, there you can also directly place some links to the internet here or to also local cameras or whatever is in your network. So these hyperlinks can be used now. And the last thing, which is also new, which was also often asked by a lot of people, is the documentation. So under system information, you see here now the documentation button create. If I want to create it, you have to put in the name, the address and so on. And this way you can create a documentation with all devices, all connections and all realized functions, how you set up the installation. So this was everything from my side. Thank you all for listening, and I hand back to Thorsten.
Yeah, thank you, Martin. It's in my opinion really great to see this consistent solution we have now, this fully integration between FreeAtom and SecureAtom. So after pairing, you can configure everything in the FreeAtom software environment, and now also with the additional sensors we have, the heat and smoke sensors, but also CO sensor. And these buttons, these emergency alarm button, I think we have a real consistent solution now and easy to handle and to implement everything. Okay, then allow me to show some final slides. Just final information. So questions we handled. Okay, information or just a reminder of our training and qualification database, where we also store this webinar, the recording of the webinar and the presentation. As always, it's always updated, and as well our training calendar. So all trainings coming this year in 2020 are already inserted. Have a look what is available. For example, we added a specific DALI seminar here in Heidelberg, and you can register over our platform, a learning management system, MyLearning, as already the last year. So, and Jürgen will also run some certified trainings this year in Heidelberg, as all these basic courses too, and the advanced and tutor course. You see here the dates, and all trainings will be followed by a 2 days application training. Yeah, with some specific topics. Also inside our training calendar, but also here in our MyLearning platform to register there. So what else? Yeah, the famous Light and Building Fair will be this year again. So every second year we have in Frankfurt the Light and Building Fair. This year relatively early, from the 8th to the 13th of March. In Frankfurt, and ABB is in a new hall. It's not hall 8 anymore, but now a new hall number 12, just for your information. But there we will show a lot, and also in Free at Home there will be some news. Good, and then the last slide from our side, information for the next webinar will be already in 1 week. So I will send out this afternoon the invitation. The webinar today was just to do our job we had to do last year, but we couldn't. So, but this webinar is a QAS, the New Energy Analyzer KNX, will be the next webinar already in 1 week. So keep in mind the 22nd of January, but again, I sent out today still the invitation. So we have now a further component in our Ecomatic family, Energy Analyzer KNX. MBUS and Modbus is already existing, but now a new component more related to KNX and with some nice features, I can promise you. Hopefully we see us again next week with our next webinar about this energy analyzer KNX. So thank you for your participation. See you next time. Bye bye. Ciao.